Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My brothers and sisters, I receive messages from people saying we've married someone who's been previously married with children. That is a noble thing. In fact, you achieve a great reward, and on condition that you take those kids as your own, as much as they may not be biologically yours, but you become connected with them, the fact that you've married the parent. So my brothers and sisters, remember, when you have the children of others, or when there is a spouse that has taken in your children, don't say to them that no matter what, my children come before you, because it's not a matter of who comes first, who comes next. It's a matter of being right, being disciplined, standing up for what's correct, standing up for values and morals, standing up for justice, being fair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. The reason I say this is people say, listen, those are my children. As for you as my spouse, I can change you anytime, but I can't change my children. People say the same things about their mothers. That's an unfair statement of blackmail. That's a statement that makes you think that you have the right to just flick off people after marrying them and thinking that that's not going to have a repercussion. You need to stand up for what's right. Discipline your children. You need to allow the spouse of yours to discipline the children that may not be his or hers, to a degree, obviously. But you must not side with the one who's wrong. You don't do that. If the parent or the person you've married happens to be cruel to your children, that's another story. But don't always believe stories of cruelty. You need to understand, pick up the signs. You need to know. And let's try and be good to each other. Even the children need a good word to say, if your father or mother has married and they now have a spouse, be supportive, be good, be kind, be obedient or dutiful, should I say, as a child. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for one and all. Because divorce is on the increase. You know, the rate is very high. At times, obviously justified. But you will be marrying someone who probably has children. That's a good thing. You need to have a very big heart to do that. Or if someone is going to marry you with your children, remember, they have sacrificed so much. At times, both parties have children. It's not a joke. And this is why it's good if you're going to be living with these children to meet the children as well in advance. Because if you're going to be living with them and you haven't met them and they really don't like you, they really don't have good characters, good character and morals, etc., you're going to struggle. May Allah make it easy for everyone. Remember, when someone has come into your marriage, you have children, treat them fairly with respect. Don't threaten them and say, listen, I'll divorce you. These children here, they come first. You know who comes first? Allah. Allah comes first. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. إِن يَكُنْ غَنِيًّا أَوْ فَقِيرًا فَاللَّهُ أَوْلَى بِهِمَا. Whether the person is wealthy or poor, Allah always is more important than both parties, which means all the parties, Allah comes first. So remember to be fair, to be kind. We need our children to grow up, and they will have to grow up in a way that is going to be beneficial for them. That's only going to happen when we have a kind understanding. You can sit them down and tell them, listen, that's my spouse. Alhamdulillah, we love each other. We'd like you all to live together in the best of harmony. There may be some misunderstandings. Remember to resolve it, not by saying, my daughter's always right and you're always wrong. This is what some people say. My son will always be right, you will always be wrong. That's not fair. What if the child is totally wrong? Who are you siding with? Shaitan, that's what it is. Don't do this. Let's make sure that we stand up for what's firm, justice, goodness, that which is balanced and fair, and that which is high in terms of morals and values. May Allah bless all our homes, and may Allah help us to marry those who've been previously married in a way that, subhanAllah, we can cater for all those who are looking for spouses. Whether they were married before or not makes it irrelevant. Good people, alhamdulillah. Sometimes, yes, I do know, it's definitely a challenge to marry someone with children, but it's very rewarding. If you can, go for it. May Allah bless you all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.